Hello, and welcome to another Linux installation tutorial. Today, I'll be installing Linux Mint alongside Windows 10 to get dual boot. The installation is a bit tricky, but I'll cover everything step by step, so following along should be pretty straightforward. Let's start by making room on the disk for Linux Mint. I use the disk management tool for that. Just right click on the Windows icon and select disk management. Here, we can see all of the partitions on the disk. As you can see, I already have free space at the end of the disk because I already had dual boot in the past. But to free up some space, right-click on the C partition and select Shrink Volume. Here you can see how much space you can free up. I recommend that you free up at least 25 GB. But I'm going to cancel as I already have free space. Now that we have freed up some space, let's move on to downloading the Linux Mint ISO file. It can be downloaded from linuxmint.com. And in the download section, we can get the latest version. Linux Mint comes with three desktop environments: Cinnamon, Mate, and XFCE. Cinnamon is probably the best known and most popular desktop environment for Linux Mint, so that's what I'm going to go with. We now need to choose a mirror. Usually it's best to choose one that's close to your location, but I went with World, the first one, and it worked great. I already downloaded the file, so I won't download it again. Next, we need to download Rufus from rufus.ie. Rufus is a tool that uses the ISO file to create a bootable USB flash drive. Rufus doesn't require installation, it's a runnable file, so let's run it. We now need a USB flash drive. We'll use it as the installation media. Notice that everything on it will be deleted, so make sure it doesn't contain anything important. And let's plug it in. And Rufus immediately recognizes it. Let's now select the Linux Mint ISO file. And let's start. Okay, our installation media is ready. I leave the USB stick plugged in, and let's restart the computer. We need to quickly tap the F12 key as soon as the Dell logo appears. Let's now open the BIOS setup. First, in System Configuration, under SATA Operation, we need to change the selection from Radon to AHCI. Linux won't be able to see the computer's internal disk, the SSD, with the Radon option. Next, under Secure Boot, we need to make sure that the Secure Boot Enable box is not checked. Let's apply the settings and exit. Again, we need to quickly tap F12. And now let's select the USB flash drive from the list. My USB flash drive is SanDisk, so that's what I choose. And start Linux Mint 20.1. The Linux Mint live session was loaded. Let's connect to the network. Right now, everything is running off the rail. So nothing is persistent and everything will be wiped out on restart. We want a real persistent installation on the SSD. So let's start the installation. Select your language and your keyboard layout. You can check the box for more codecs and better media compatibility. The installer sees that we have Windows installed on the computer. Since we already freed up disk space on Windows for Linux Mint, we can now choose Install alongside Windows. And the installer will use this disk space for Linux Mint. And we can see that two partitions are going to be affected. The first one, NVMe1, that's the system partition. And it needs to be affected so that grub can be loaded when the computer starts. And from grub, we can start Linux Mint. The second one, partition 5, is the free space on the disk. If you want to see for yourself, just to make sure that these are the correct partitions, you can use the disks utility. And here we can see NVMe1, which is EFI system partition. And the last partition we currently have is partition 4. So a new partition will be created on the free space. Select your location. We need to type in a name, a computer's name, a username, and a password. And Linux Mint is being installed. And the installation is done. Let's restart the computer. We now need to remove the USB flash drive and press enter. And we are presented to the grub menu. From here, we can start either Linux Mint or Windows. The problem we currently have is that since we changed the SATA operation to AHCI, Windows will not load. Let's enter again the UEFI settings, which we can do directly from the grub menu instead of using F12. The thing is that Windows can work with the AHCI option, but it needs additional drivers to be able to do it. So what we're going to do is temporarily change it back to RAID on, load Windows and install these needed drivers. Then we will come back here and change it back to AHCI. So let's temporarily change it back to RAID on. And let's select Windows from the list. We're not going to manually install any drivers. We will let Windows take care of it for us. All we have to do is start Windows in safe boot, while SATA is configured to AHCI. The first time Windows loads in safe boot with AHCI, the drivers will be installed automatically, and then we won't need safe boot anymore. To enable safe boot, let's look for system configuration. And in the boot tab, I'm going to choose safe boot. And let's restart. And now we're going to change SATA back to HCI and leave it this way. And now let's load Windows again. And now, since Windows is in safe boot and SATA is configured to AHCI, the needed drivers were installed. So we can turn off safe boot. And when we load Windows now, it works just fine, even though we are in AHCI. We can also take a look at the device manager. And we now have SATA AHCI controller installed. Okay, let's restart and log into Linux Mint. And Linux Mint is up and running, ready for use. You might find out that whenever you log into Windows, the time is wrong. Luckily, it's really easy to fix, and I found the solution in the System76 support site. By the way, System76 are the guys behind Pop OS. I leave a link in the video description below. And at the very bottom of the page, there is a section about fixing the system clock. And I'll just copy the line from their website and paste it to my terminal. After running it, you may have to fix the time one less time in Windows, but once you do that, the time will be displayed correctly. One last question you might have is, can we change the default operating system? Because right now, the grab menu loads by default. And then if we don't press anything, Linux Mint starts. And if we want to start Windows, we have to actively choose it from the list. So we can change it to be the other way around. Windows will load by default. And only when we want to start Linux Mint, we'll use the F12 key to start the boot menu. To change it, let's open the UEFI settings again. In the boot sequence, we can see Windows and Ubuntu, which is actually Linux Mint. We're going to change the order, so Windows will be in the top of the list. And now, when the computer starts, it will always load Windows, unless we tap F12 and deliberately choose Linux Mint. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.